today. From AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. It's week 5 of the NFL on EA Sports. Cowboys taking on the New York Giants.
Just a gorgeous fall afternoon in the heart of Texas. No weather to speak of. Sun out, roof open. Yes, yes, and yes. A great day for football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. A moment ago, here was the scene with the Cowboys emerging from their tunnel. It was loud. It's still loud. We're ready for football as the Cowboys get set to match up with the New York Giants. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
From the 31, Prescott, and he'll hit the slant route. That's caught by Cooper. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
Cowboys.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double-team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
Throw for Prescott. Looking for Cooper, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Blake Martinez. So here are the Giants under head coach Joe Judge. And a look here at their go-to guy under center.
Well, he did go 2-2 in the last ball game. Well, actually, he went 2-2-1, with the one being the victory.
Yeah.
That's the bottom line there. But wasn't it funny at practice? He threw one when we were watching through an interception, and the defense got on him a little bit, good-naturedly, but they're letting him know you got to cut down those interceptions. We can't bail you out all the time.
Yeah, two touchdowns, two picks, but as you said, they got the win in that effort last week. Finding Sterling Shepard for his first catch. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. That's a good way to start the drive, 17 yards and a first down. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. Now a man open down the middle of the field. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. The numbers in last week's contest for Ingram. 10 catches, 81 yards, and a touchdown.
Look, I know everybody wants to be number one in everything they do, but he's number two in the league in receiving yards. That's a strong number, a strong year, and they want that to continue.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10.
I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion, but this time the defense was all over it, and they got there to break that one up.
4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. Skill, whatever the case is, they're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, our ball. I mean, they don't care if it was luck or skill. Boy, the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground, whether you get it or your teammate gets it, just as long as you maintain possession, that's all you're looking for.
On fourth down, on is Graham Gano for the Giants' field goal. On the left hash mark, this a 38-yard attempt. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through.
Is good.
And the Giants are off now to a 3-0 lead.
Three. Cowboys nothing.
In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points. Maybe not the touchdown that they wanted, though.
Yeah, but bottom line, they wanted to get something out of that drive, and they did that. 3 points, they won't turn that down at all.
And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30.
Pollard on the return. The Cowboys take over first and 10.
Dak Prescott of the offense heading back onto the field. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know that are the best ones, the ones that really know how to lead their team, they tell them, that's on me. That's my bad. But let's go back out there and move ahead again, guys. We can get this done.
One good thing for him, it did only lead to 3 points and not a touchdown after that turnover.
Big thanks to the defense.
The numbers for Zeke from last week. 14 carries, 57 yards, and a touchdown as well.
I can't remember the last time we did a game and a coach didn't talk about establishing the run first. But they've lost 2 straight games, so they still want to do that. But they've got to have some contingencies, some other options. Expect them maybe to throw it a little bit to open up things and maybe run it a little bit more later in the game.
It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to 3rd and 10.
Yeah, that was a safety that came through and made the play. But there's no doubt in my mind, he hits like a linebacker. We see a lot of that in today's NFL, don't we?
And that time, we do indeed. A big hit for a loss. It's Prescott. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds. So a big call there that brings up fourth.
That certainly looks like nothing to show now from these first two possessions. And guess what? When you're on a losing streak, that can lead to a full sense of here we go again. So on the sidelines, the offensive play callers, quarterback, they've got to get together and dial something up to start their next drive. Otherwise, it could be a long game.
So on fourth down, here's Chris Jones to punt it away. Yeah, last week in the loss, 5 punts as he gets this one away. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And it'll be Giant football, 1st and 10. So the Giants getting the football back here for their second drive. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for 3, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking.
And the Cowboys' pressure gets there this time for the sack.
DeMarcus Lawrence.
Defensive end DeMarcus Lawrence applied the heat. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's a really difficult task.
Work to be done here on 2nd and 16 after the sack. Yeah. It's complete to Golden Tate.
The pass.
They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down.
That's a good bounce back play right there after taking a sack on first down. Didn't quite get it to the marker, but now they're in a much better spot for a third and short yardage call. Through the offensive coordinator, you'd like looking at that section a heck of a lot better than trying to figure out third and long.
False start, offense.
And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. And a manageable third down becomes a lot less manageable. Third and seven after the false start. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Got a man, Slayton. And he will have a Giants first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A big one there on third down. They hit for 30 yards.
For a quarterback, there's two sides to this coin. Either he had complete faith that his guy would go up and get the ball, or his throw was up for grabs. Which one do you think he'll tell the coach when he goes to the sidelines?
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. Barkley hit and the ball pops free. And it's picked up by the Cowboys. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line. There are two words that we hear coaches say all of the time. One starts with a B, one starts with an S. Ball security.
And they preach it. They have it up in meeting rooms, right? You see the signs. They talk about it all the time. But still, when you've got defenders out there who are preaching, hey, we're going to take the ball away from you, no matter what position you play, you've got to take care of the rock.
They start on the ground with Elliott. And he's going to get this past the 50 and into Giant territory.
Number 21.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Brought down by Blake Martinez.
From the shotgun, a give to Elliott. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3 yard gain brings up a third down.
Three. Brings up third and two.
They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been 4 down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, so if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
So after a good run by Zeke, another first and 10. They'll try to throw now. Prescott out to the right here to Wilson. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. He's going to find Gallup here complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 12 yards there and a first down.
Well, this is where reading defenses and practice time comes into play. You've got to know what you're running versus zone versus man and how to run the proper route. And they just executed that one pretty well.
A first down carry by Elliott. And they go the wrong way here. Knocked back to the 20. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
And that's exactly what you're looking for at the inside linebacker spot. Versatility. He can drop into coverage, or as he did on that last play, use his speed to get to the perimeter and knock the ball carrier for a loss.
On second down, Elliott. And not much to speak of there. Maybe a yard down to the 20.
Ball carrier.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down.
Third and
now Prescott. And he's able to hook up with Michael Gallup. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out.
The previous
Timing is everything, and they work on this cut all the time. They work on all the timing patterns, and this time it paid off for them. Worked him to the center of the field, cut it to the outside, ball's delivered, gets both feet down for the completion.
Zerline for the Cowboy field goal.
And the challenge pays dividends. The ref overturns the play.
Everyone gets a bonus on this one, Brandon. The coach upstairs who says has signaled down and said challenge it, and the head coach for pulling the red flag.
That ties the game at 3-3.
So they do get 3 points, but that's now three drives with only the 3 points, not a ratio that's going to win you many ball games.
Not at all, Brandon. And think about it this way. We all know payoff is the key, right? And wouldn't we love to have the concession on every T-shirt that's been printed in football that says finish on it? Because that's the mantra everywhere. Got to be able to finish drives, put points on the board.
And New York set to take the field. And they got across the 50 last time, but fumbled and turned it over. So they'll be looking to have a short-term memory here, Mr. Davis.
Not only a short-term memory, but a whole lot better ball security. Because if they take care of the ball, continue to move it, their chances of scoring some points, they got to feel pretty good about. They thought they had things moving in the right direction last time. Fumbles, they don't just affect you on offense, they affect your overall team because now your defense has to make that stand up.
A big play there for the Giants. 52 yards. We know he's good at catching the football, but then after the catch, he's got escapability.
Not only that, he's got some toughness as well because you know he's coached very hard to make sure he battles through, breaks tackles, and then they finish with, but don't fumble the football.
So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. Now Saquon Barkley, and he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of two, and it brings up second down.
Tyrone Crawford on the stop. A gain of two.
Here's second and eight.
Second and eight.
They'll complete this to Ingram as tight end, and they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line.
Complete to Evan Ingram. A gain of 9 yards.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. On the run, it's Barkley. And this play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back to the 15. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
They have three tight ends in that formation. That's almost a universal sign that they're planning to run the football. But how about the defense there? They met force with force and caused a stack up behind the line of scrimmage and threw it for a loss.
Second down, here's Barkley. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line.
Barkley again, the ball carrier.
5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. This is caught. And the Giants are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Great mix of play calling so far. Three runs, three passes. All three passes have been completions. First and goal.
I think on defense now, you have to almost take a chance. Rely on your scouting. Pick a play you think they would run here and just load up for it and see what happens.
And they've got three tight ends here on first and goal to add some extra mass. And Barkley will try to punch it in. And he is in. Touchdown, New York.
Saquon Barkley, the ball.
Saquon Barkley, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Giants have taken the lead. And nothing special there. They show they were going to run the football. They ran it. They got it in.
Like old-time football, right? Hey, this is exactly what we're going to do. Straight ahead power, and they got it done.
Graham Gano on for the extra point. And it is up.
The kick is good.
And it's good. That'll make our score 10-3 now. So that drives seven plays in length. And it's capped off by a touchdown run from Saquon Barkley.
Graham Gano.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24 yards.
The Cowboys offense heading back out and ready to go again. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Second and
throwing on second down. Prescott got an open man, the tight end Jarwin. 5 yards. Now it's third and five. The last play on the completion got them half of what they needed. Now here's a tough third and five. This to Jarwin. And he will have a Cowboys first down as he's able to get 8 yards there on third and five. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
10th carry now for Alliott. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
Prescott with the give to Ezekiel Elliott. He was brought down by Blake Martinez. A gain of
10-3 our score after one here on EA Sports. Working with second and five now. Out of the gun, it's Elliott. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what'll be a third and four. Open man, Lamb, it's complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Prescott's throw going to be caught by Gallup. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 11 yards and a Cowboy first down.
38-yard line.
Looking to throw, Prescott. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. Prescott yet again. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And now they pause for an injured player, and that injured player is an important one. Ezekiel Elliott still down. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. The Cowboys on third down. They've been good, 3-for-4 thus far. This is third and nine. And again, it's Prescott. And that will be incomplete. So two third down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a third, and now they deal with fourth down.
A 53.
Yeah, this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. And that'll bring him back within four.
Cowboys six.
These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right, baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
Here's a look at Golden Tate as he heads back onto the field now. Well, September sure treated him kindly. Now we flip over to October. Any reason to think that those numbers drop, or can he keep the pace up?
Well, he can keep the pace up, but it's going to get a lot more difficult now. To me, it's a lot like baseball, all right? When guys, you know, when they first hit the league, whether it's a pitcher or a hitter, and they go through the league the first time and they're hot, they're going, wow, what a phenom. Then they get tape on them, they get scouting reports, they start to do different things. Let's see if he's going to adapt and expand his game in order to keep up that type of production.
That's a good call, because he's a known entity. See how they defend him going forward. The tackle there by Antoine Woods.
The 35-yard line. 1 yard gain.
Second and nine now. Gets this out to Saquon Barkley. And he's brought down, but not before a really nice stiff arm to create a little space.
Saquon Barkley. It's a gain of six. And it's...
They'll try to run for it with Barkley. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. Now a look at Smith. Not sure exactly what happened, but he's still down. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. A pair of first downs gives him a first and 10 up at the 44. This is Barkley. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
When a draw works, it can be a thing of beauty. But when it doesn't, oh, it can be ugly. And in this case, loss of yardage ugly.
Second and 11. Back to throw. Looking for Shepherd deep. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Brown. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line.
Intercepted.
Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their 35-yard line. So the drive's going to start with Pollard. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
Partner, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
10 at the 49-yard line.
Play fake. Here's Prescott. Under pressure here, and down he goes. Sack back at about the 43-yard line. Lorenzo Carter. The blitz works to perfection as he gets in there to dump him for a loss of 8. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Another try after the first down sack. Prescott able to hit his target, Lamb. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time.
That's a gain of 4. Brings up third and 14.
Third and long for Prescott. The tight end Jarwin with it out on the left side. And they do get this across midfield to the 49, but a small consolation prize as he's well short of the first.
Excellent job there defensively. Gave up the underneath to the tight end on third down, and they made sure that they did their job. Got him on the ground and prevented him picking up a first down.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he'll come on to kick this one away. No returning this one. It sails out of bounds, and they'll spot it right at the 20.
At their own 20.
Saquon Barkley and the Giants offense set to kick off their next drive. Whatever he was doing in September, they're hoping that that carries over now to October because he was sensational last month.
He absolutely was, and we all know where it started. At the end of last season, right? All the offseason preparation, the weight workouts, the sprints, right? The vision that he had, what he was going to do this season. And, of course, it all came together with the rest of the team. Those big fellas up front, leverage, and boy, are they getting downfield and creating extra blocks for him.
They really are. Everyone's been doing their job so far to create those holes. From the 26, they'll line up on second and 4. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Jalen Smith. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. They brought the house that time on the young rookie, maybe a little rattled through the pick.
And you have to be prepared for a lot of pressure as a rookie quarterback because most defensive coordinators are going to test you that way. So when you see that, the ball's got to get out of your hands quickly, and that means your receivers have to understand they have to break off their routes quickly as well.
Interception. Here's Prescott. And a quick throw here. That's complete. And they'll get this down to the 10. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down.
First and 10 at the 10-yard line.
On the draw, it's Pollard. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down.
As a linebacker, you're taught to stay just slightly behind the ball carrier just in case he makes a cutback. But when you find the gap, shoot it. And he found it all right, took it straight into the backfield, and made the tackle for a loss.
On second down, it's Pollard. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Tony Pollard, his second touchdown on the season. And the Cowboys have retaken the lead.
I wonder if he changed anything on his play sheet or they just executed better. Because they had two previous drives that ended in field goals. Before this one, they finally were able to put into the end zone.
Well, whatever he did, speaking of the offensive coordinator, might be using that formula going forward. It worked there.
Yeah, it worked very well. He and his field general in pretty good sync right now. They're starting to move the ball well.
Surline connects on the extra point, and that gives him a 3-point lead. Now after the touchdown, it's Surline. He'll kick it away. Pettis now on the return. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
Dante Pettis on the return. The Giants take over first and 10.
New York ready to go again offensively. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership.
The pass.
7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he was unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Second and three. Finds his tight end, Ingram. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
And the Giants' first down.
Barkley. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47. A good run, got 7 on first. Here's second and 3.
A 7-yard pickup brings up second and 3.
There's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 39.
A gain of 14. First down, Giants.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. Chidobe Awuzie there to make the play in coverage.
It certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
On second down now, Barkley. And he's got this pretty close to a first down at the Cowboys 30. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with 3rd and 1.
And it's 3rd down.
On 3rd down, Barkley. And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. Give him 2 yards on that play, and it'll move the chains.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
First down carry for Barkley, and he'll get about 4 as he's brought down at the 24.
Giant ball carrier.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6.
A gain of 4. It's now 2nd and 6.
A first carry for the Clemson man, Wayne Gallman. And he's got this pretty close to a first down at the Cowboys' 19-yard line. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. 9th play coming up here on this drive. This is 3rd and 1 yard. He'll look to throw. They'll set up the screen to Barkley. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. It's an 11-yard pickup. Thought they'd run it on 3rd and 1. Not the case. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
2nd and goal at the Cowboys' 6-yard line.
They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And a minuscule gain of maybe 1 yard from the 6 to the 5. They get only 1 yard there. Now it's 3rd and goal. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
A 24-yard attempt.
And Gano's kick is right through. And that's going to tie us at 13.
The game, 13-all.
So they get the field goal, but that was a 14-play drive to get 3.
It's not like you're going negative on me.
I was.
Sounds like you're thinking the three is just not that good.
And people say that we're negative sometimes.
Well, here's the deal. Getting a three is good. Obviously, you would think on a 14-play drive you're going to get six out of it. But that type of a drive can pay dividends later on because you might wear the defense down.
On first and 10, Prescott. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. First down. And it's caught inside the 30. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Boy, 30 more yards and another first down. That's evidence of why you spend a high draft pick on a receiver, isn't it, Charles?
It certainly is. His ability to make plays like that, and we've seen flashes of it from him so far in his rookie season. But also, it opens things up for the rest of the offense because they have to bring their attention to him as well.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Prescott from the gun. This one to Jarwin over the middle. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. Three receivers head out right, one to the left on second and three. To the air again, Prescott. He's going to find Gallup here complete. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
At the 14-yard line.
From the red zone now, Prescott got his man there, complete to Gallup, and he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. Ball on the 8, it's second and 4. They'll throw again, Prescott, the quick slant caught. Yeah, the Cowboys to looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line. So we come upon halftime with a tie score, 13-all, as we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
All right, Brandon, we'll get back to you guys in a bit, but first let's take a look around the NFL here on this first Sunday of October. We'll get started up at FedEx Field in our nation's capital, where it was the visiting Rams who come in and get the victory on the road. 20-6 was the final. From there, let's make the quick trip up the parkway and check in on the Ravens at home in Baltimore. And they were winners in that one over the visiting Cincinnati Bengals. 34-24, the final score. Lastly, let's get to Pittsburgh. Check on the Steelers at home at Heinz Field. And things didn't work out for him as they fall to the visiting Philadelphia Eagles. A field goal was the difference. 27-24, the final. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been as tight as we expected, all tied through one half of play. For the call of the second half, let's get it back to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Back on offense, New York gets set to take over. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. So, Charles, tie game here. What are your keys as we continue to play this second half?
I know people think it's always trite when you say the same things over and over, but they're tried and true in the game of football. Who's going to block better? Who's going to tackle better? In this case, to me, it's turnovers. You've got to take care of the football in order to win the game.
They'll wind up losing 4 yards on the play, and that'll force upon them a 3rd and 14. And that screen there on second down certainly didn't develop how they had hoped. Is that one they should have even tried, or is that one the quarterback sticks in his pocket?
I think the latter. I like what you said there, because trying is one thing. We can second guess just about every call. But in this case, when you realize it is broken down, just throw it at the feet of your intended receiver so that no one can pick it off, right? You don't have the ball tipped up in the air, and you come back and try to pick up the first down on third down. That way you don't lose any yardage.
That's going to bring up 4th down, only a gain of 2 there. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion, and what you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
Here's Riley Dixon now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. And the win last week punted 4 times as this one's away. Fair catch called for and made at about the 32-yard line. A 41-yard punt there with no return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a 1st and 10. The Cowboys offense now, they head out for their first possession of the second half. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at a certain time?
A battle for it, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Logan Ryan, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
And New York set to take the field, and they're coming off a 3 and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a 1st down.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit, because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into some windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had played him, especially a 2nd interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
Back to throw now on 1st down. Over the middle, complete to Tate.
The pass.
7 yards to pick up there.
It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd and 3 at the 31-yard line.
On 2nd down, Barkley. Call it a gain of 3, but not enough to move the sticks. It'll be 3rd and about a foot or 2.
Made by Jalen Smith. It's a gain of 3. Brings up
out of the gun. They'll look to throw. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's 4th down.
It's always a goal, and it's really nice defensively when you can rally to the football and make sure there's enough contact to force an incompletion.
Force an incompletion and force another punt. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. The Dallas offense back out onto the field. And last time, 1 play, interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a 1 play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give him a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
On 2nd down, here's a keeper by the QB. And the giant rush gets home as down he goes.
You know, on these types of plays, we're always looking to assess blame. Okay, where did it break down? Sometimes it's just a great play.
They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds. So a big call there. That brings up fourth. That one doesn't find its target, but all in all, he's been much sharper this week. He was under 50% a week ago, and now he's up over 70%.
But you know it's standard for quarterbacks and receivers to get together for a little extra time each and every day in practice. I get the sense they got together for a lot of extra time this week to try and improve that passing percentage, and it's worked out quite well.
New York ready to go again offensively. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively, just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
And a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. The catch and run, good for 24 yards.
You don't always expect tight ends to be big in terms of run after the catch, but after that play, he joins a growing band of players that's putting that stereotype right on its ear.
First down, Barkley. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two.
It's a gain of eight. Brings up second.
Again, it's Barkley.
At the 41 yard line.
And he's got this pretty close to a first down at the Cowboys 36. So from the 36 now, first and 10.
It's a gain of six. And the Giants.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. That's complete. He's got Barkley out of the backfield. And this will be a gain of five as he gets it to the 30.
Barkley.
Second and five after the 5 yard completion on first down. On the draw, this is Barkley. And he's got this pretty close to a first down at the Cowboys 25.
Tackled at the 25 yard line. It's a gain of six. First down.
They'll look to throw now on first down. And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked. Antoine Woods able to get him for a loss of about three.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big-time sack.
So maybe just a momentary setback on what's been a great drive so far, but second and 13 here. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Tyrone Crawford picks up his second sack of the afternoon. And on that one, the protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
Ninth play of the drive now on third and a country mile. He'll look to throw. He'll get this out to Barkley, complete. And he's going to get forward for about five, but that may be coming back. What say you, Mr. Referee?
Man, this is ridiculous, man.
So instead of giving them another third down, they'll decline it, brings up four.
Now that's smart football right there. You don't even have to really spend a lot of time considering it. Just know that you're probably going to get the ball back. Good job declining that penalty.
His kick is good. Makes the score Giants 16. Cowboys 13.
So it's his third field goal now with the ball game, and they needed his leg. This last one gives him the lead.
It's been a back and forth kind of a game, hasn't it? Now you got to tell your defense, guys, need you to make this stand up because we got the momentum going in the right direction, but we need you to make sure we carry it home.
Pollard on the return. The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 26.
Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They'll start with the option. And he can't get away from the pressure. The Giants get there. Credit that sack to Jabal Sheard. Decided to keep it that time on the option. Got out left, but the defense was right there.
And you know what happened on that play, right? Because the defense, as you said, not letting him get upfield. No place for him to ever duck his shoulders and turn upfield and gain yardage. Had to keep moving out laterally. Nice play by the defenders.
Second and 14 as they've got work to do here after the sack. Another try after the first down sack. Prescott firing quickly here, and that's complete.
Prescott's pass.
They'll get nine there as that sets him up better for third down.
It's a gain of nine. Makes it third and four.
From the shotgun, it's Prescott. On the left side, Gallup's got it. And he will have a Cowboys first down. He needed five. He got it barely, as it will officially go down as a gain of 5 yards. So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll run with Pollard. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. On second down, here's the option. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42.
Tony Pollard, the ball carrier.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to see?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. Got from the gun on third. Open man Lamb. It's complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down as he'll be marked down a yard or two past the marker following a gain of 6.
First and 10.
But give the defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat them on that play, did they?
No, the drag, that guy can be your safety valve we saw right there.
Yeah, and it picked up a first down for him, too.
Couple of first downs on the drive already as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. Now Prescott. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Amari Cooper, the intended target, and that'll bring up second down.
It's now second and 10.
They run here with Rico Dowdle. And he's going to get this past the 50 and into Giant territory. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
To throw is Prescott. And Prescott, his 3rd interception. Picked off at the 45. And he will bring it back. It's a pick 6 and a Giants touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Cano now to add the extra point. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him three more.
The Cowboys take over first and 10.